Welcome to this Excel tutorial where I'm going to show you 5 simple tips for creating number sequences in your worksheet. And they can increment nicely 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or we can have a custom step value 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on. We will use basic methods in the worksheet, formulas, and custom functions for more advanced usages, as well as a bonus tip over here. After this tutorial, you should have everything you need for every situation that requires you incrementing a number in Excel. And don't forget you can download this file from teachexcel.com. I'll put a link to it below this video. As well, we have full Excel courses on TeachExcel that help you automate your workflow and save hours of time every single week. I'll also link to those courses and include a nice discount with it. Now let me clear this worksheet and let's begin. Method 1 is the simple trusty autofill. Type in the first number, type in the second number, select them, and click the handle in the corner of the cell, the quick fill handle, and there you go. You want to increment it, let's say 5 and 10. What we can do, actually, since we already have an existing list, is double click that guy. If you want to do it going to the right as well, you can do the same thing. And drag it to the right. Now let's go for fill series. This is perfect when you have a much larger list, and this will take a long time to do by hand. So what we want to do is to put the very first number in the cell, then go to Home, Editing, Fill, Series. For series in, we have rows. If we wanted to go across a single row, so over multiple columns, and columns if we wanted to go up and down within a single column. For type, stick with linear. Step value is how much do you want to increment it every single cell. We'll leave it at 1 for now, and we'll go 1 to 10. The stop value is the last number. If we wanted it to go 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on, we could put a 5 in the first cell. Let's clear this out. And very easy. Columns linear, step value 5, stop value 50. Okay. Perfect. Next up is a function for newer versions of Excel, equals sequence. And here, very easy, we can just hit 10 and there we go, 1 to 10. That's the simplest way to use it. But we have many more options: rows, columns, start, and step. So I will very quickly go over these. You can do a lot of really cool stuff with sequence that's beyond this tutorial. So for columns, if we put 2, it'll go across 2 columns. We want to leave that at 1. For start value, let's go 1. Step value, 1. How many rows? 10. So we'll go 1 to 10. This is the long version of what I just showed you. We could also go 5 and a step value of 5. So it starts at 5, goes up by 5. Perfect. Now the thing with this is that the formula spills down. If you want to make it so it's actually just the numbers you see, we can select everything, copy it, right click, and paste values. And we have just the numbers. You can also paste values, by the way, old school, Alt-ESV, Enter, my favorite, or Control-Shift-V. Now let's move on to slightly more advanced, the row and the column function. These are going to be used when you have much bigger, more complex formulas, and you need them to increment by 1. And I have many amazing advanced tutorials that show you how to do that. The premise is you type equals row, give it a cell reference, let's say A1, and it returned the number of that row. Well, it's row 1, so we get 1. Since we have used relative references, we can copy down, and it will increment by 1. For column, that's how we go left to right. Equals, column, A1, and we can copy it to the right. And the final bonus tip is select the cells into which you want a number. Type equals row A1, close it up, control enter. There you go. You want to freeze them real quick right now? Control C, control shift V. Escape, escape. And there you go. That's just a fun little bonus tip. Remember, in Excel, there are a million different ways to do things. Now, if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you get all of our future tutorials. And don't forget to download this file from teachexcel.com. It is completely free. And check out our online Excel courses while you're there that will help you automate your workflow and save hours of time. I'll put a link to those below this video as well and even include a discount. So give them a look. That's all for this video. See you next time.